Hello there, I'm Liz from Imagineer. This is an explainer video for a series of templates that we've got available on the Imagineer website. So you can find the templates by going on the website and looking under useful information, and there will be a whole section on templates that are available for download, free for families and individuals, and a very small charge for anybody that's coming from a professional background. So this video is for decision-making agreements. And we've often found in the work that we've done that people that were working alongside and people that were establishing a support brokerage relationship with have often found themselves in positions where other people in their life are making decisions on their behalf. That could be professionals, it could be family, it could be friends. But ultimately, what's the core of the work that we do and our ethos is for the person to be in the driving seat of their own lives and therefore making their own decisions about what's important to them and what they want to see happening in their life. So the decision-making agreement is just a really, really good way of capturing what them decisions are and having a record of them decisions. Can be really useful in situations where people might have a fluctuating condition, where they experience certain days where expressing the decisions and what they want to have happening is not as easy. And the decision-making agreement can be a really good reference point on them kind of days for anybody providing support, whether that's in a paid or unpaid capacity. Can be great for people who have very unique approaches to communication and where the decision making can work fine when they're around people who lean into that unique style of communication. But the decision making agreement can be really useful when they're forming new relationships or spending time with people that they don't spend a lot of time with. And the decision making agreement can then be really useful in informing that conversation. And it can be useful as well for people with long-term conditions that are progressive. So we recognise that there will come a time in life where the person's engagement in decision-making may decrease. And the decision-making agreement that was written at a time where they were actively involved in them conversations could then go on to inform future decision-making. So I'm sure, as you can imagine, that this is incredibly useful at points of addressing capacity and best interest decision making and best interest meetings as well. So that's there and it's available. The outline of the decision making agreement is capturing the important decisions in the person's life, whether that is big decisions around health interventions or where I live, or if it's small decisions about what I have for breakfast and what I'd like to wear today. So the decision-making agreement captures the important decisions from the person's perspective, how they like to make that decision, if they like to make that decision on their own, or if they want support with that decision. And if that is the case, who the person wants to support them with that decision. So it's quite thorough. One of the things we always remind people of is that anything of this sort is only as good as the day it was written. So if we recognize a decision-making agreement is going to be a useful document, just mindful of keeping checking in with that and making sure that it's up to date and it's relevant for relevant for life right now. So thank you very much, and we hope you find it useful.